Can I say bonjour?
Parfait.
Bonjour.
The first question is obvious for you, sir. Most of the writers that I talk to hate touching their books for the big screen, hate being even involved with it. You seem to be the exception. Why?
Well, I don't know if I'm the exception. I think occasionally writers have a very nice experience with the movies, but Hollywood does take a lot of liberties, and in this case, I had approval of the actors, I had approval over the script, I had approval of the director, so I had a lot of influence. I don't like to flaunt the influence, but I would not let them make mistakes.
Okay, so what did you see in Rob, for example, in the director? Because he's known to take material and change stuff or adjust things. He talks to the actors and asks them for their own ideas. How did the two of you work it out?
I think the big thing with Rob was in talking to him and what he wanted to do with the movie and what he wanted to do with his career. He wanted to make a suspense movie, and he had good ideas about how to make this particular suspense movie.
What did you
and he had a lot of experience. And, you know, I think that, you know, if you look at what has happened out here, you now have a situation where television is looked at as better than movies in a lot of cases. And that's a storyteller's medium. Storytellers run it. I think the film medium has turned more into art directors talking to bureaucrats. And I don't think that's necessarily good for storytelling. Rob got in here, and he had a very coherent story that he wanted to tell.
I need obviously to ask you about Morgan Freeman, because you've been involved since the beginning.
Yeah.
Was it a shock? Was it difficult to get somebody else inside of him? What was your reaction?
I don't think it was that hard. I mean, look, Morgan is in his 70s now, so it starts to become troublesome, the idea that he's going to be a detective in the movie. So. And I think Morgan probably felt the same thing. So it was, the thing when you write the books, I'm smart enough to know that even though there's a year between the books, the character only is 1 week older. Mm-hmm. So he's, takes 10 years for him to be 10 weeks older.
So why
Tyler? He's going to stay this age.
What did you see in Tyler?
What I saw in Tyler was a very, very smart person, very focused. And when I went to talk to him in Atlanta, he said, James, I wouldn't touch this if I wasn't sure I could do it. And I'm going to give myself over to this director. You will not have an ego person on your hand. I'm going to get much more physically attuned for this part. And I can do it. And I felt he could. He's very, very smart. He is very strong-willed. And I've seen all his movies. And obviously he does comedy extremely well. But the dramatic parts, there was plenty there to see that I felt he could do it. That he needed to amp it all up a little bit, but that he would be very good.
Merci beaucoup. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.